ora, good evening. Tonight we're discussing the demise of the Women's Studies course at Victoria University, and with us in the studio is special guest and graduate of that course, journalist John Campbell. Welcome, John, and thank you for coming to the show.
It's lovely to be on my own seat. It's very, very exciting.
When did you sign up for the course?
I don't really remember, but it must have been about 83 or 84, I think. And it occurred to me, and I was only doing literature, that's all I did. I only did literature papers. So I did classics if it was literature, I did Russian if it was literature, but mostly I was doing English lit. And it occurred to me that in 3 years, two full years, it must have been my third year, I hadn't read, I think I'd read one female author. Staggeringly, I must have done dozens and dozens of authors. And then there was this paper called Women in Literature, which was in the Women's Studies Department. And obviously it was only female authors, and I thought, well, I should do that.
You were the only male on the course for 2 years. Did you score?
No. I failed spectacularly to score. I was very earnest. Mm. I mean, I think probably secretly deep inside myself, you know, that had action been available to the only chap on the course, then I would have, you know, been readily, you know, forthcoming. But I don't, in good faith, I don't think that's why I was there. The first tutorial was one of the most uncomfortable hours I'd ever had in my 18 or 19 years on the planet, which was a very sheltered and cosseted life. But we went round, unfortunately, we went round clockwise describing our experiences of being a woman, starting on my left. And without exception, these women had all been the victims of some appalling behaviour, you know, and then that got to me. You know,
I sort of
apologised, really, on behalf of... I can't really remember what but I remember, you know, that my voice was, you know, it's probably, oh, goodness. You know, you think, shit, you know, this is unbelievable. People were crying and comforting each other. You know, I was sitting there like, you know, the sort of KKK member of a, you know, at a Martin Luther King rally, just feeling like a total, like a turkey. But, it, you know, it was great. I think life is about being as two-eyed as possible. I just think that's our responsibility. I just think that's what we're here for, to see the world in two-eyed terms. And that was part of the process of being as two-eyed as I possibly could be. So I feel there's absolutely no doubt in my mind that it was important and valid and critical when I was 18, 19, 20 or whatever, that universities needed it and the country needed it and we all needed it. I hope that's less the case now. We've had two female prime ministers. You know, the CEO of this company is a woman. My last two bosses have been women. You know, CEO of Telecom, the previous one was... You know, I think, you know, those glass ceilings that hadn't been broken when I was a student have all been broken now, and I hope that means that women's studies is... But maybe we still need it just for different reasons.
Mm. Given the recent antics of our prime minister appearing on Tony Veitch's radio show to discuss whether women are hot or not, do you think that suggests we need this course more now than ever?
I get a bit confused about this stuff. At some level, whilst, you know, Sue Kedgley and the bourgeoisie of Grey Lynn are kind of appalled by John Key saying, you know, Liz Hurley is hot, actually, the vast majority of middle New Zealand are thinking, well, she is hot. You know, she is. And so the question is, how do we have these conversations? Mm-hmm. What's the language in which it's okay to say, isn't Liz Hurley a gorgeous woman? She may be as thick as a plank, and she's clearly dating a moron, but every time I look at her, I think, whoa. You know, how do we have those conversations? Mm. And what terms is it okay to say that stuff when people feel it? I don't know about having it with Tony Veitch, necessarily. I don't know. Did I answer your question?